times people live with a spirit of poverty on them all of their lives and generationally. Now listen, when Karen and I got married, I had a spirit of poverty on me. Literally had a spirit of poverty. We didn't have anything. And when I was growing up, I didn't live in poverty, but I lived the next step up. Is my parents were, they had three boys, they were trying to survive, you know, and get along, and they provided for us well, but we didn't have an abundance when I was growing up. And when Karen and I got married, I never thought I would have an abundance. I literally looked back on it, and I had a spirit of poverty, and I believe that I would have carried it with me for the rest of my life because of the way that I thought. And so sometimes people carry with them generationally a spirit of poverty or a spirit of lack where it's like, we've never been ahead. My family growing up was this way, I'm this way, and I literally cannot see a future for me that has financial prosperity. And I know that some of you right now, you're going to be listening to this and you can identify with that. And part of what's going to happen now in this seminar and in this message is that's going to come off of you and you're going to see yourself blessed by God. And not only are you going to be set free from a generational spirit of poverty and lack, you are going to pass on to your children and grandchildren a spirit of abundance and blessing. And so we're gonna reverse the financial curse. But sometimes it's not just like a generational curse. Sometimes it's situational. It is where in a bad economy, in a difficult time, we were just at a certain place at a certain time and something just, you know, happened to us that happened to everybody else. In this last season that we've had this recession, the worst recession since the 1930s, no one saw that coming. The greatest experts in the world did not see that coming, and many people were just vulnerable. They lost their jobs, they lost their business, or they went into a very bad situation economically because of that. In other words, it's not necessarily because we sinned. It's not necessarily because we did something wrong. We were just in a bad place and a bad time. But regardless of whether it's generational and there's a spirit attached to it, or it's situational. In other words, whether you jumped in the hole or someone pushed you in the hole, you're just in a hole. And I want to use that analogy in this message of how to get out of a financial hole and to live in abundance for the rest of your life. Now, this is Isaiah 61, and this is about Jesus. This is in the Old Testament. It's a messianic prophecy talking about Jesus. It says, "The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor." Now, that's interesting. Now, poor obviously means spiritually poor, people that need God, but also poor. "He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God." The acceptable year of the Lord is the year of Jubilee. Jubilee is when all slaves went free and all debt was remitted. Do you know that our bankruptcy laws in the United States of America are fashioned after the Levitical laws of the Old Testament because God never wanted a person to go into long-term debt? Many people who came to America came out of nations that had debtors' prisons. That once you got into debt for generations or for the rest of your life, you were then a prisoner to that debt and you couldn't do anything. It took away your hope. It took away your legacy. And what God said in God's system, God said, no one is going to be in debt for the rest of their lives. Is that I am going to proclaim a year of Jubilee every 50th year. Every 7 years was a sabbatical year, but every 50th year, there was a Jubilee year, and all slaves were set free, and all debt was remitted. And it says that Jesus came to bring good news to the poor. And Jesus always paid attention to the poor, a special group of people in his mind, financially poor, and to proclaim the year of Jubilee. And so God wants us to be free financially. And I'm not telling you to file for bankruptcy or anything like that, unless it's just an absolute necessity. But here's what I am saying. If you want to be free financially, you've got a friend in God.
Thank you for joining us. Experience the life-changing series, You, Me, and Money, on CD or DVD. Follow your interests and get social by connecting with Jimmy and Karen and the Ministry of Marriage Today on Twitter. Looking for your next great book? Start reading instantly with Marriage Today's eBooks, now available online. Marriage Today's latest book, Lifelong Love Affair, is an essential tool couples can turn to again and again for inspiration and strength. Order your copy today. Become a rock-solid partner today and equip yourself with the tools you need for a successful marriage. $14, $28, or $56 per month. Choose the partnership level that's right for you. Become a rock-solid partner today.